Howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I'm not even sure that I set this up correctly so that it would go to where it needed to go. So, anyway, moving on. So, I want to tell you, I don't know if you remember when I interviewed Dee's Delicious Cookies and then Diana's Blooms, her cupcakes that look like pieces of artwork, and how their families have grown since this and done better and bigger, and it's an amazing deal. I've got more stuff to share with you on that, but I'd want you to go, if you're interested in following these people that are starting from home, and it blows my mind. They've turned these into huge businesses. And it's exciting for me that some of them share this stuff with us. There's a lady doing spices. There's so much stuff. So anyway, if you, are interested at all, in that, I hope that this is going to where it's supposed to. I thought I did, but I'm not sure I did. So, you have to let me know. Is this broadcast on YouTube? Is it being broadcast live on YouTube? Space Coast Hot Dogs in the house. What up? So, Johnny Hayden's here. Brian's here. Art Make Pieces in the house. Mac Daddy's Dogs Catering. Jim Trotter, thanks for being here. Nikita Shelton's here. Craig, thanks for being here. Okay, good. Thank you for letting me know. I didn't know if I hit the right button, and I was excited to share some of this. So Dee's Cookies, Diana's Blooms, both of those, two different separate companies, separate families. You need to check them out. If you haven't already, follow them. Follow them and get motivated, because it motivates me every day when Diana pumps out some beautiful piece of artwork that's edible on cupcakes. Hey, Melissa. Hey, Jay. Trevor. All right, so why I'm here today is because a new vendor sent me a video, his setup and everything, and said I could share it. He goes, go ahead and share it. So I haven't even watched the whole thing. And so it's two parts, and we're going to go through it and maybe give you some ideas. And if you've got questions, I'll try to get to those too. But I am kind of in a hurry. I got somebody waiting on me, and I'm going to try to do my best to do this. Let me pull in the other video. So I'm going to go to here. All right. So this is Jeff, and he's working here on a Cater Pro cart. And this is first setup, I believe. And here we go.
What's going on, guys? Hey, it's Jeff here with the, Ben's Cater Pro cart.
Hey, before I move on, can somebody tell me if you can hear this? Can you tell me that you can hear it on the video that I just started playing? I want to make sure I have that right. Just type it in. Type it in. Say yes or no. Tell me if you can hear me. Can you hear me? Oh, good, 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 good. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it.
So a little bit of my setup right here. So right here we have some water is heating up for the beef dogs. We got a couple of cloves of garlic in there, two beef cubes. Same thing for this, two beef cubes, bouillon cubes, shall I say, and some garlic in there as well, two cloves of garlic. This is
That's ridiculous. Something happened. Don't know what happened, but we're back, and we should be good. And I'm gonna go right back to the video here. This is going to make a mess of things, I'm sure, but this will be out of order. But
what's going on, guys? Beef dogs. We got a couple of cloves of garlic in there, two beef cubes. Same thing for this, two beef cubes, bouillon cubes, shall I say, and some garlic in there as well, two cloves of garlic. This, I just got water in today. I was going to sell some sausages, but I decided not to. Here's just a steam pan. Here we got the Coke onions. Here we have the sauerkraut. And right here is the chili. If you guys are wondering what kind of chili we're serving, it's just a Hormel with no beans. Got the grill right here. I'm going to steal a trick from Frankenstein's, the butter spray. I'm going to butter the top of the buns, stick them on here along with the dogs when they come out for about 30 seconds. get those 60 grill marks, or sexy grill marks, what Ben calls them. Of course, you got the trash can and propane there. This down here, this bucket here is what I use for the hot dog water when I'm done with it, because it does have grease in it, and I usually put that in the commissary sink. Walk around here, my Clorox water, sanitation water. I always check that as well. I always got my Clorox strips, or my little test strips for that. Make sure it's over 200 ppm. That's what my health inspector likes. Of course, I got the water here. Got this set up here. Got my tinfoil here for the dogs, my gloves, the buns I get from Sam's Club. I think they're $2.69 for a 16 pack. Back up a little bit and see what they can see everything. Of everything. I also stole that idea right here for the trash can with the foot that lifts it up. Got that from the Doug's Dogs. All my drinks are in here. All the chips, I'll get those out in a bit. We're not going to start serving for another 30, 45 minutes, so those will come out shortly. Always put those up last. Got some napkins. Again, I stole that idea from Doug's Dogs. Back up and see this over here. Oh, I got my sign out front. This is Highway 74 in Shelby.
So he's in Shelby, North Carolina, just so you know. And he's, you see how good he's set up. He's made it easy for people to spot him. I love this. And I hopefully you're learning something here as far as you'll pick up on something maybe that you didn't know. Hopefully it's, hopefully you can hear me. Some kind of error message on my screen.
Beside the Domino's pizza. Here's what I have for my condiments. Got the secret relish, some jalapenos, homemade coleslaw, which everybody says it tastes just like KFC's. And again, I stole another idea from Doug's Dogs, the red onions. Another idea I stole from Doug's Dogs. Keep this off of the metal here, but that is a San Jamar condiment caddy. I think I paid $45 for it. I also have the ice packs beneath it, if you can see through there. Now here's where I keep my...
You notice that one? That's something I teach in my course book. When you do this San Jamar or any of the brands, you can do an off brand, doesn't matter. He has the gel packs. Anytime you can use gel packs so that you don't have the ice and water to deal with, you just refreeze them when you get home.
Dogs. Been using some ballpark just because everybody's loving them. Again, I stole that idea from Frankenstein's when he's up in Waynesville, which Waynesville's only about maybe, I don't know, an hour and a half from me. Apron. Always wearing my apron. Something else I always like to do as well, I always keep my thermometer in there, just for the health inspector.
Great point. Many health inspectors will like think you're the coolest vendor in the world that you have a thermometer handy at all times, because that's what they're most concerned about is food safety more than anything, so they'll temp check stuff.
As far as water, I always put purified water in my dogs. I know you don't have to, but I always use distilled water from the steam tray down here. It's the tray that holds the water for the steam. So, but yeah, that's my setup. This is our second time out. I was going to come out last week, but I had knee surgery, but back out here at it again. Last week, we made about $350 profit off of this for our first time.
Okay, so it wasn't his first time. I had skimmed through this video, and I heard that first time, and I was thinking it was his first time out. We have more, though. We have part two of this. I'm going to throw it up here for us.
Yeah, sorry about that. Got cut off there. Again, our first time out, we made about $350 profit after everything was said and done. Last week, like I said, I had knee surgery. I was going to come out anyway, but I left the regulator that goes to the propane. It started dragging the ground, so when I got to set up the site for last week, there was a hole in the regulator, so I just nixed all last week. and just started fresh this week. But anyway, guys, like I said, this is my setup. Welcome any criticism, but it'll be better next time. Next time
I also have a
one of those easy up tents over here. It's just with my knee, can't really put it up right now, but yeah.
I just want to say
thanks to Ben for everything. Thanks for the whole community for everything you guys do for us. Thanks so much.
All right, so that was it on Jeff. I want to read you something, though, because he's updated me since this video was sent to me. He said he visited Cleveland County Health Department, got a score of 99 that afternoon. He was penalized 1 point due to my sanitation bottle of Clorox water not being labeled. Talk about being nervous. I get it. You're always nervous when you meet those inspectors. I thought it would be a great location to set up, and goes what I secured that location as well. So he got a new location. The business owner was more than happy to allow us to vent in front of their business 3 to 4 times this week as well. One location being from across from the Shelby's large hospital. I feel confident I can secure those locations as well. You know, you say hot dogs saved my life. Well, guess what? I had knee surgery last week due to an injury on the job, and I was denied workers' comp. My wife is a stay-at-home mom, so my family depends on me. I can officially say that hot dog business has allowed me to provide my family during a time I cannot work. I'm a plumber. Hot dog vending has kept food on my family's table, and I thank you and the other folks out there, Frankenstein's, Doug's Dogs, and the others. P.S. Grilling the hot dogs on the grill using the Crisco butter spray has really wowed my customers. Talk to you soon, Jeff. And there's his, he even sent me his thing. Well, you can't see it, obviously, but he sent me his inspection, 99. I never got a 99, I always 94, 95. My inspector always said, I don't give hundreds. I can always find something wrong. And they do. So, then an update, a little bit after that, another 300 net profit day. I worked 11 to 2, so much fun. Quick update, I've secured 4 locations and have 2 banks that want me at their locations as well. By the way, I had numerous people tell me dogs are the best they've ever had. It's all due to your recipes and techniques. Also, I've had 1 bad day so far, but still made $210 after expenses. So divide that up 11 to 2, 3 into 210 is his worst day. That would be, what's that, $70 an hour net profit. I'm not kidding you, folks. If you're on the fence about vending, don't be. It's a guaranteed. I used to have a preacher who'd say, I'm a money-back guaranteed preacher. I'm going to pass the plate, and if you don't get your blessings from these tithes, he goes, you come back, and I'll give your money back. His name was Billy Gower, great friend of mine. He was up in Kentucky. And so what I want you to know, though, is that you apply these simple things. It's not like somebody's going to go, well, you need to study for 11 hours a day. You got to read these books. You got to write a thesis. You got to do this. No, you can have no education, third grade education, come out here and just follow a few simple steps and you will be successful. Now, I will tell you that people like Jeff, you get into Vendors United and now you've got 500 plus vendors at your fingertips who are kicking butt and they're helping you. And some of them aren't even street food vendors. They're doing cupcakes. They're doing kettle corn from home, shipping it out. All these things legal. So I teach all this at kitcheninincome.com. It's right up there, kitcheninincome.com. But if you want to learn about hot dogs, I'm going to put this real quick. Come on. Learnhotdogs.com is a fantastic place. You get all the information for free. You don't have to buy anything. You can search it and find it, okay? There's a search box. Type in a word. You can find it. Getting started, you just go to the top of the screen, hit the start thing, and it'll walk you step-by-step on what to do. I teach you about how to find the best deals on a used cart, how to get a used cart really cheap, how to talk them down, how to work with them. So many ideas that I can pass to you so that you have this kind of freedom. Here, Jeff is a professional plumber. and had his leg hurt and had to go earn money. So he gets a Cater Pro and he's out there making money. And he's averaging over 300 for his 3 hours net. That's net. That means profit after expenses, everything, over 300 each day. Well, to figure that up, if you work 5 days a week, that's 1,500 a week, okay? Per month, that's over $6,000 because there's 4.3 weeks in a month, right? So a lot of value there if you want to grab it, and I hope you want to grab it. William says it's not that easy, serious. No, I've always said this is hard work. It's not easy. Easy is winning the lottery, maybe. That, you know, once you win, that was easy. But if you want something that is tried and true and works for anyone that does it, and actually does it, follows the steps, and doesn't try to just go willy-nilly and go, well, how hard can it be to sell a hot dog? It isn't that hard to sell a hot dog. But you're going to want to do this the right way, and you will come out ahead. You will make a lot of money, as much as you want to make. We've got vendors that are making over $300,000 a year with one food truck, one food trailer. We've got vendors that are kicking butt. We've got vendors doing $80,000 a year part-time, just part-time work, okay, 4 or 5 days a month. That's a day a week, 1 day a week, and they're making $80,000. You can meet those people in Vendors United. You can go to vendorsunited.com. I'll let you in for free. I don't like restrict you from anything. So the free courses and all that stuff, you get it free. Just like you were a paying member. So you ought to check that out. Thank you, whoever you are that said that love your videos. I appreciate that. I'm going to help you out maybe. I don't have the link here. I don't know why it's not here. Anyway, there's a thing that allows, I guess, Facebook to share whoever you are on here. You have to give permission now. Let's see. This is fantastic. I have a hot dog cart in Peggy's Cove in Nova Scotia, Canada. We got tons of tourists coming through the village. Hard work for sure, but so much fun. Thanks so much. Claire, that you make a good point, and I'm glad you actually said it. It's hard work. It's 11 to 2. How many jobs have you had that were easy, where you could make $300 a day profit? Okay, so these guys are going out, like Jeff goes out for 3 hours. Now, I want to be honest with you. It isn't like it's a 3 hour day, because you got prep and then you got cleanup. So you probably got about 5 hours total. Okay, so some guys do it a little quicker, but if you do a really good job, about 5 hours if you're doing a three-hour day. You can count on about an hour on each end, and then 1 day a week, you're probably sourcing products, you're working from home, calling, figuring out which is the best broadline distributor for me. Hey, I want to get a new bun that's split top, that's made fresh, that has some wheat germ in it, or whatever. So you're spending other time too, but nowhere near 40 hours a week. Nowhere near it. So, I wish I could get everybody to do it that wants to change their life, that wants to be independent, that wants to be free, that wants to be just basically be their own boss, but in such a good way. You know, it's a difference between buying your own job. It's kind of like mowing yards. You can go out and mow yards, and if you really want to make a really good living, it's going to take a long time. You're going to have to work 6, 7, 8, 10 hours a day. And you're making a certain amount, basically, per yard. And if you quit, you don't make any money. With this, you can hire people and split the profit. It's what I teach in my book. It's how I got to 22 carts in a year in a little town. And you're going, well, how did they do that? Well, they were all around me. There was vendors all around me from Knoxville to Newport, Tennessee. There were vendors that I had set up in carts. And it works. It works for everyone. Do this, though. If you do join Vendors United, even for the free time, I'd say wait till like Wednesday of this week so that you can be included and join us for the Monday night mastermind session. It'll blow your mind. The vendors, so many women. It happened to fall on the Women's Day, the Women's Appreciation Day, the national holiday yesterday. And we didn't even do this intentionally, but most of the people that talked in VU last night in our mastermind were the women, the female vendors. And they'd blow your mind how good they do. They always do better than the men. And it's because I think they're more approachable. I've always said that. I think they're more approachable. And they're where a man, you know, it may not be as approachable. Still doable though. I've got a vendor that's kicking butt, and I wish that he'd get on here. But he averaged, you know, 150, 225 a day. 225 was a good day. And last year he's averaging 600-700 a day. Same location, same everything. Okay. But he changed a few little things. And that's the stuff you pick up in VU. So let's see. Tomorrow, my first year anniversary since I got my initial inspection approval. I can't believe it's been a year already. Art, Mac Daddy Dogs, it blows my mind. It doesn't feel that long because I remember when you started and I didn't realize it's been that long. Congratulations, Art. You've done a fantastic job and Art's one of these guys that he's smart, so he comes up with ideas, but he also listens to others. So he's in our VU meetings. He's on the page, the private page, and he's picking up stuff. But then he twists it and makes it work for him, and he picks the stuff he wants. I call it eat the meat and throw out the bones. Could you talk about mini donuts for just a couple of minutes? I want to know your recommendation on selling anything less than a dozen at a time. Yeah, vendors do sell five and six, especially the ones they top really pretty. They'll sell five or six. Most of them are selling five because of the way it fits in these boats or these containers, these flat containers, because they decorate them up. If you'd have been in VU last night, you'd have seen these vendors doing these maple bacon glazed. That's totally fried food truck, Keith, in our group. And he shared his pictures last night, and it makes you want to lick the screen, you know. It's phenomenal. Yes, you can do it, okay? I would suggest, even if you just take advantage of the free days that you know, the five free days with VU, get in there and ask Keith. Ask the other donut vendors in there and go, what are you doing? What are you doing to sell less donuts? How are you doing it? And do it that way. I hope that helped you. I hope what I did helped you. Cheap cart. I actually have a whole article on where to find the cheapest carts, how to buy it, how to get it. So Bass Finder, go to learnhotdogs.com and type in, you can type in just hot dog cart or anything, and it'll pull up those articles that I've done, and you'll see the one about how to get the best deal on a used cart. And it tells you where. Look at that. Bill Shea says, because of being in Vendors United, I qualified for a 5,000 SBA grant, free money, so that I wouldn't have otherwise known about, and launched us during COVID crush, our first year goals. So thanks for sharing that, Bill. I'd forgotten about that. I want to make sure. You're welcome, Bass Finder. Now look at this. Art says, and I'm blown away. Art even shared this. I think it just tells me a lot about Art. I love Art, and I think it's awesome that he shares that. 56,000. Somebody asked him, "What'd you make?" 56,000. And is Art working 7 days a week, 12 hours a day? Nope. Art's just thorough. He knows his locations. He takes advice. So if somebody says, "Hey, you should move the sign here, do this or that," he does it. And he'll probably double that number this year. I'd be surprised if he doesn't double that number this year. Awesome, Jonathan. Jonathan says, I'm going to open up my tent in Charleston, South Carolina at the end of the month. Super excited for under $2,000. Freaking awesome. Howdy. Will from Memphis. Glad you're here, Will. Let's see. Hey, Art, some people don't, some health inspectors don't care about the flip top. They count the lid as the cover, so they're good. Or the umbrella. So just it just depends on the inspector you get. Okay, I think that's it. I love you. I want you to, if you need help or want to get started, it's out there for you. It's here. And so this may not be your cup of tea, and you've probably already turned it off by now. But if it is, change your stuff. If you're a vendor and you're not making the kind of money you think you should make or want to make more, we'll show you how to double it, triple it, and with real people's stories, real people in the group that you can talk to, people that made $30,000 a year for the first 6 years, and then they joined Vendors United, and they're making $120,000 this year, or they made $94,000 last year. So, and you get to talk to these people. So, and they help you, and they tell you what they did, and what's the two best things I did, and what I changed, and what I learned from Jason, or Corey, or Mark, or Keith, or Ken, and they help you. And then, because we have so many vendors doing other foods too, like Ken does lemonade, and then he does, and that's where he began, and he's got hot dogs, and then he's got, and then there's vendors with donuts, and funnel cakes, and kettle corn, and boiled peanuts, and we're killing it. We're killing it. So, Jay, thank you for that. Art, Wake County is the worst county in the state of North Carolina. So I know all the inspectors there, Rebecca, and I know them all. I've had it out with all of them. Anyway, I hope y'all have a awesome evening. And I love you, and keep going. Keep going. Holler at me anytime. You can email me at ben@vendorsunited.com or ben@learnhotdogs.com, and I'll answer. Talk to you soon. Bye.